गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास। Okay, so I hope all have submitted ISC 1. If anyone missing, you can send it directly to me today up to 1 p.m. Means after this, you can send it, or else I will consider your absent mark for the same. Now we'll try to focus on the tutorial parts, where today we are going to cover these many things. So first we will understand what is object diagram, how to draw the object diagram. Then we will focus on what is class diagram, and then we will focus on how to draw the class diagram. And to do the hands-on session, we will take few case studies that we will try to draw for the first hospital management system, and then we will try for this banking system, then air transportation systems, library information system, water management system, supermarket information system. These many hands-ons we are going to perform. So let's start with the basic idea, what is class diagram, and for the same we are going to use Star UML tool. So let's start directly with the tool. So see how I'm starting the tool. Previous lecture I have shown you how to install it. Go to an option, Star UML, search it. Select, always prefer to select an option with a rational approach. Say okay. The four most important part, you have to save the project. So go to the file and save as, click on the save as, give the name tutorial first. And class object diagram, simply this part, and save this. Again, the same you can do. Rename this as same cute first. This, as I rightly mentioned, we are going to focus only on two types of a diagram. The first is an object diagram, and second is the class diagram. During our class, we have discussed what is object diagram, what is class diagram. So basic idea is, object diagram, first we need to focus on the four objects, and once you complete this activity, very easily we can focus on the next part called as what, class. So object is nothing but anything. That may be a concept, that the things what we can see through our eyes, we cannot see through our eyes, or maybe even for the conceptual part also, still we are going to call it as one object. And next is one, how to represent object in UML. We have discussed, it's a very simple one. Object can be represented just a simple rectangle. So if we see, if you are remembering this, I'll show you. Just a second. Okay, all of you start the Star UML tool. Just all of you start the Star UML tool. Yes, all of you, just start. So, what is an object? As we know, as per the definition, object is nothing but anything in the real world. We will call it as an object. And what is class? Class is nothing but group of objects having some common attributes. We'll call it simply as a collection of objects. What we can say to understand the class. So, object is instance of the class where class is blueprint, or simply we can say template from which objects are created. So object is real world entity such as maybe pen, laptop, mobile, whereas class is simply a group of similar objects. Now representing that class or representing that objects and that are interacting with each other with respect to a specific project or with respect to specific task, we can use a separate diagrams. So let's see some sample diagrams and then I'll show you. I'm starting with the star UML. Okay. See here. Tutorial first, I'll go to this logical view, add diagram, and I'll select the diagram first. If you see here, class diagram. And I will rename the class diagram as Hospital Management System. It is expected that before starting to draw the class diagram, you have completed the object diagram. Because without knowing the objects, you cannot know what the class will be there. So simply class represents a collection or a group of similar objects. So simply is what we can say. No need to go for the separate drawing of an object diagram. We can start directly with the simple class diagrams. So I'm trying with the first as a simple class diagram, hospital management system. Now how to represent the class? So simple notation is, if you see here, if you able to see on my screen, this is a class. I can drag and drop here. So this is just a class. Class represented with a rectangle having three compartments. So first compartment we are calling as a name. That is called as what? Class name. So I'm representing here. Class. This is class name. Second compartment tells us about attributes. Attributes means named properties of the class. So for example, class name, I'm just for understanding, I'm telling this here as a car. Now attributes of car, these are attributes of car. Now the first attribute is red color. For example, I'm showing it red. Second attributes, year of the manufacturer. That is, it is manufactured in year 2021. So these are the attributes. Attributes are nothing but named property of the class. Now, second, third compartment is it's in operations, means how your car or how your class is going to act and react. We will call it as what? Operations. So simply remember, operations are nothing but methods, nothing but behaviors. How your class, particular class, is going to perform throughout your project scenarios, that will be decided as a part of your operations. So add operations. I will show you car. First operation I am saying moving. Second operation I can add. Second operation I will add as a part of mileage performance. So this is simple, called as one class. So class is nothing but a rectangle with represents, which we basically represent three compartment. First compartment called as what? Class name. Second compartment we are calling attributes, and third compartments we are calling it as what? Operations, which are in fact nothing but methods, behaviors. Okay, so this, if you are aware, now we are focusing on the most important part. We are talking about hospital management system. Now, considering this hospital management system, we need to identify the different objects, and collection of that objects we are simply calling as one class. So rather than going for a separate object diagram, we will show the objects as itself in the class diagram. So I am trying to draw the class diagram. So let's focus on the hospital management system. If you are aware about this basic notations, I'll simply delete this. If you are aware about this, I will add one more diagram here. Add a diagram, select class diagram. Hospital management. Okay, so when I think I'm starting with the first idea about the hospital, no doubt the first class or the first element coming in my mind is I'll call simply hospital management . Okay. Second class that I will focus on, doctors. Third, I will focus on patients. Then this is the name we will simply call as a management part. These are the doctors, this may be possible the patients. Then we need support staff, the support staff to the doctors. So I'll add separate as nurse or brothers. This as a third, one more entity is okay. Doctors there, patient there, then appointment, one tracking system there will be as an appointment. Appointment will be there. Next, doctors will suggest some medicines. Doctors may suggest some what we can say, lab or test So accordingly, I'll add the class first lab tests. But lab, I'm talking test maybe regarding X-ray sonography or maybe blood test, etc. So lab comma test. Next, I'll suggest as prescriptions. We call simply medicines. Medicines comma prescription. Prescriptions advised by the doctor. So these are the possible classes that will come as a part of hospital management system. Anything that will be added over here? Any guess? If I'm missing any point, please let me know. We are simply focusing on the hospital management system. So basically, hospital management system where doctors will be there, patients will be there, then supporting staff, I'm calling simply nurse brothers. Then patients need to take the appointments to the doctors. Doctors will observe the patients and based on that, will suggest some tests if required, or we can directly, they can give the directly medicines to the patients depending on the criticalness, depending on the conditions of the patients. Okay. Is anything remaining here? Okay, so we need to take worry about the one more part I'll call as the most important part, billing system. That billing system will be responsible for that billing system will be responsible to take the charges from the patients and also will able to generate the what we can say salary for the doctors. So all informations, even salary for the nurse brothers also, all information with respect to that will be considered as a part of billing system. So I'm considering this as a one more class over here. Okay. Is anything missing you can add? Yes. Please reply. Yes, any point I'm missing as far as the hospital management system is considered? Okay. If later also we can add it. Okay. Now let's focus on each one of them. Now we need to concentrate on each of the class, and for each of the class we need to find out attributes, we need to find out operations. So if you are remembering how I'm going with this class diagram, or what are the basically steps to draw the class diagram. First I said identify different classes, name them properly. Third, we need to think about attributes. So attributes are nothing but named properties of the class. Fourth, we need to focus on operations, which are nothing but methods, nothing but behavior. Attributes, these are nothing but, for understanding I'm saying this, these are nothing but named properties. And then the last moment that we need to define the relationship among the various entities. So identify different classes. This will be decided based on problem statement. Now, which problem statement we are focusing? We are focusing now hospital management system. Hospital management system. So for that we have identified different classes. So these are my different classes which will be the part of hospital management system. So first, as I identified as a management perspective, so I said hospital management. Second, doctors. Third, patients. Then supporting staff, nurses, brothers. Then appointments, lab test, medicines, and next is billing system. One more I can add. If patient is going to get admit, so we need to think about the rooms and all. So I'll add one more class here. Rooms, beds. So one more class I identified. So we need to understand first the problem statement very clearly. So, and based on the problem statement, we can perform this task. So I just simply identified these many classes, maybe the part of the hospital management system. Okay. I have done the step. I have completed this step. Now need to think on the attributes. So what is attributes? Attributes are nothing but named properties of the class. We'll call them as one attribute. So example, I have taken car. So to identify the car, what the uniqueness is over there? So it may be a number, then color, year, manufacturing year. So that can easily makes us to identify that specific object or that specific class. We are calling them as what? Attributes. Even if I consider class as a student, so name of that student, roll number of that student, academic year, these parts indicates the attributes. So let's focus on the first. I'm talking as a hospital management. I can easily add the attributes. How to add the attributes? There are the two methods. See here, this is class. I can attributes in two style. The first is select that specific class, right click, add. You are getting here an option as a attribute. So how to add the class? By using star UML, select that specific class, right click, add, and select an option attribute. This is the one way. Or select the specific class, go to the properties, and you will get here an option called as what? Attributes. Select this. If you click here, you can able to perform the operations. See here, attributes you can add. Operations you want to add, you can add operations also. So select this. The choice is yours. I'll go with a simple method. Select this, right click, add. Attributes. How to add the attributes? This is the simple method. Print script I have just taken. I'll add one more step over here. How to add attribute to class. Simplest part. Select class, then right click, select add. This is the simplest way to add the attributes. Select the specific class, right click, add attribute. Now this what it shows, these are the, if you select this, these are showing the visibility. Now what is visibility? So that you might have studied in OOPS also. So private, protected, public, or default, these are their visibilities or the access specifiers, how you are making it. So whenever there is a concept called as what, generalization or specialization or inheritance concept comes, In that case, you need to think about this properties visibility. So I'll keep by default now as an attribute. Now attributes, I'm telling named properties of the class. So I have added one attribute over here, and I just want to rename it. So attribute which is added over here, I can change the name. So the first attribute with respect to this is we need to make it uniquely. So I'll call hospital ID. I'll rename it. We'll add as a hospital ID. Then close this. I'll add one more attribute. Right click, add attribute. I'll rename it directly as hospital name. Hospital name. Then attribute hospital place or address. Hospital address. Then add one more attribute. Add attribute. I will add hospital type as hospital type. What this attribute specifies, hospital type, whether that specific hospital is a multi-specialty hospital is there, or simple consultancy OPD type of hospital is there, like that. So I'm calling this as an hospital type. So this is just I'm considering as a part of hospital management. This will able to identify that hospital uniquely. So these are the some properties with respect to that hospital. Now, second part that I need to take into the consideration about operations, what that hospital is going to perform, or methods, behaviors that it is going to happen. That part I will add as a part of operations. So right click. Now the process to add the operation is select this particular class, right click, add, and select the operations, select the option as an operation. Take this one more step. How to add the operations? How to add operations. The simplest process is select class, right click, add operation. Then select operation, and most important part, rename it. This is the simple method to add the operations. I hope you all are getting my screen. I'm visible because just the light has been gone over here, but still I'm able to perform the operation. Is it visible to all? Reply something yes, no. Are you getting the steps what I'm showing? Okay, thank you, Siddhi. Thank you. So now, okay. Now what I'm selecting, I'll select one more class here. Again, hospital management. And I will select an option, and I'll select the operation. Now, the first operation that with respect to the hospital management I'm telling is Search means what the things. Add hospital means details if you want to add, that you can add as a part of add hospitals. So I'm using add hospital. I'm selecting the first option as add hospitals. Then if already a hospital is there, if you want to make some changes over there, that else you can do as simply edit. I'll say an option edit. Edit hospitals. Then if I want to add entry with respect to that, if anything happen over there, that can be done. So I'll perform simply over here as a search hospital. I'll save this. Whatever the things you are adding over here, make an habit to save it. You can simply use Control S option by default there to save the things. So this is what I did with hospital management. So if you consider this as a part of a hospital management system, this class is going to play a particular important role, because everything with respect to hospital will be starting with this. So this will be responsible. The operations will be responsible to add operations. Means I can say simply add doctors, add or remove the doctors will be responsible. Then add operations, patients that are managing that patients. To which patients will be given to which doctors, that all part will be done as a hospital management, or which room or which bed will be allocated to the which specific patient. This part will be accepted as a part of a hospital management system. Then for the billing process, they will be the responsible. So entirely the billing process, that billing process with respect to doctors, with respect to patients, with respect to brothers, with respect to this will be as a part of the hospital management system only. So still there are some attributes, operations are there, we will try to add as a part of a coming. Now let's focus on one more class. So let's focus on the doctor class. So doctor attributes, I will add attributes. So simply we will select this, and in one I'll show you with one more options over here. I'll select these options. Okay, now first I will add attributes. Attribute first attribute with respect to doctor, that doctor ID. Edit. So I'll add as a simple doctor ID. I'll add one more attribute. So click here, attribute, doctor ID, then doctor name. Edit. University or doctor hyphen name. Then doctor name, done. Okay. Then we need to identify what is the specialty of that doctor. Means he is a special, whether he is MD medicine, or whether he is a what we can say, eye specialist or skin specialist, like that. So select this, enter, edit, doctor, can say doctor specialist. I'll add doctor specialist. Then I need to take the mobile number of a doctor. So edit. डॉक्टर मोबाइल नंबर, देन आई नीड टू टेक द एड्रेस ऑफ द डॉक्टर, सो इडिट. एड्रेस एड्रेस ऑफ द डॉक्टर, देन एडिट. आई नीड टू असाइन अ यूनिक, व्हाट वी कैन से, यूनिक आईडी एंड पासवर्ड, सो अकॉर्डिंगली आई विल से ईमेल आईडी. डॉक्टर user id, specific id I am giving them, the uid, assigning them with the specific password also. So these are the attributes I have added. Now I will add operations, what doctor is going to perform, what operations doctor is going to perform. So I will add doctor methods or operations. I will see here. So first we'll be able to perform the edit doctor. Edit doctors, then edit means his personal details he want to change. Means suppose one particular doctor has been appointed as a simple, what we can say, after completion of his MBBS, he has joined that specific hospital. But within 2 years or 3 years, he or she might has completed his or her post graduation, like maybe MD or maybe an MS. So should be able to edit. So I have say then an option, edit doctors as an operation part. Then I can specify if I want to recommend other doctors. So I need to able to search the doctors also, whoever available. So accordingly that I can select an option. Search doctors. This is the thing what I can say with respect to doctors. Now, similarly, I can show with patients. I'll add 2 to 3 samples just to complete this part. Now, second part with respect to this, what we can see, this billing systems will be add operations. Yeah, sorry, I'll complete with patients first, and then we will go one by one by. First attributes with respect to patients, that patient ID. Then name of the patient, patient address, patient mobile number. It's one of the important part. The patient mobile number, I need to think about the edit patient blood group. Patient body mass index BMI. Then operations with respect to patients, that add patient, edit patient. Add patient. Then you can say simply as edit patient. Edit means for the update purpose. Edit patient again, specific again. I can say search patent patient also. Sorry, then edit. Close this. Added with the patients, doctors. That number doesn't matter, huh? The way I have added, just for the simplicity, I am saying. Billing system will come as a next part. Okay. Now first, I will think about the all human beings first related to the hospital management. So doctor there, patient there. And I'll go to an option, nurse. I'll bring that part here. So this billing system. Now I will consider this as a billing system. And now add attributes, add operations. So select this option, add attributes. So nurse or brothers, these are nothing but these entities which will help the doctors. Or once the doctor left the room, this nurse or brothers will be responsible to take care for the patients. Patient la kai hawai nako hai kiwa kai problems patient la aale emergency la tar te nurse kiwa brothers note kartat ani immediately te doctors la inform kartat kutla golya kiti vasta dyaycha divasatun kiti golya dyaycha ahe he sagla responsible kon ahet te specific to this nurse and brothers. So what will be an attributes over there? So we need to identify uniquely, so their ID again same, like I'll say simply as nurse comma brother ID. Then we need to add their name. We need to add their address, Diksha. Timing of the class is 10. You're joining at 10:50, almost 1 hour late. Okay, brother ID. Then I can add mobile number. So edit. Add mobile number. Okay, similarly to the doctors, we are giving them unique user ID and password also. So add, edit this. User ID, unique user ID. And similarly, they need to set accordingly a specific password. So this is the points we'll add over there with respect to nurse or brothers. Now operations, with respect to this. So add, edit, update, search. Simple. Should able to perform add. Second is edit. And most important part, search. This I have done with this brothers, sisters. Then we need to think about the appointment attributes. Okay, next. So just think about who is going to take the appointment. Patient. Patient will interact to the hospital management. We'll talk about the problems. Then hospital management, based on the patient's problem, will suggest the doctors, or specifically they will ask the this hospital management that I am facing this problems and I want to take appointment with this specific doctors. So what will be an attributes over there? So we need to uniquely identify that appointment. So I will add attributes with respect to this. Simply I'll click here, add attributes. So appointment ID. Appointment ID. Second, we need to think about the doctor. So doctor ID, accordingly we can add same doctor ID. Doctor ID. Then we need to give specific number. So appointment number. Appointment number. Okay. Then appointment just casualty, or maybe admit. So like that, or maybe for specific operation. So we need to decide the appointment type. Appointment type. Then most important part, date. Appointment date, specific time, date and time. Appointment date and time. This will be an attributes. Operations. So what this specific appointment is going to perform will be able to add the appointments as usual. The first operation will be add appointments. Add appointments. Okay. Then edit appointments. Edit appointments. Then edit means again will be able to perform the delete options also, or update options also. Then with respect to appointments, we can add save on search appointments. Can add search appointments. Search appointments. with respect to appointments. Now, next I can focus is on specific medicines. In case of medicines, I can think about attributes. So attributes, I will add simply through this. So attributes like medicine ID. ID, then name of that medicine. I'll say medicine name. I'll add one more attribute here, then medicine company. Again, we need to think about one of the major important part. Medicine company, because though there are again different vendors are there, same medicines will be prepared by different companies, prices will be different. So you might be aware about the new concept there. Generic medicine concept is also there. Same, actually the content, chemical contents are the same, but the names given to that are the difference. And based on the company name, prices are going to get changed. So that we need to think about this medicine company. Then we need to think about the most important part with respect to this is composition, these chemical parts added over there. So medicine compositions. Medicine compositions. Then medicine type. Now what it indicates, medicine type. The type ahe ka liquid ahe, like that. So medicine type. Then we can add as medicine dose. How many times in a day we are going to take? दिवसातून एकदाच घ्यायचं आहे, दोनदा घ्यायचं आहे, तीनदा घ्यायचं आहे, लाईक दिस. दॅट स्पेसिफिक डोस वी कॅन टेक. Medicine dose we can add, and then medicine description, just for the simplicity. काय करते ते medicine? It's an optional part, but we will take into the consideration medicine description. This we can take into the consideration. Price also you can take here for the billing purpose. You can add the medicine price also. Again, it is an optional part. Medicine price. Then operations with respect to this, you can add like add, edit, update, correct? Add. Add medicines. The next, edit medicines. Search medicines. Search medicines. So So this I have added with respect to, then same again with whatever we have seen with this, similarly we can add. I'll show it quickly. So with respect to this, with respect to lab, I can go to this, add attributes. Okay, with respect to lab and test, so ID, lab or test ID, we need to identify. Lab comma test ID. And which test they have suggested, so, or which lab they have suggested. Lab, I'm thinking about blood, or that may be regarding urine. And that test may be with respect to, based on that type of test. So lab comma test. ID, then type. Just for simplicity, I'm adding this. Then operations, add. Test. Add lab comma test. Then edit. Test. And search. Lab comma test. These are the possible operations I have just added. Okay. Then room beds attributes we can add over here. Attributes, then specific, we need to think about the room ID. Room comma bed should be identified by uniquely. So I'm saying them as an giving specific ID. Then it is a type. It is single room or double room, or it is ICU type or semi ICU type, like that we can add. For the billing purpose, based on the charges of this room allocation. Room or bed allocation. Kadhi dile tya particular patient la kiwa suruvatila patient aalyala ICU madhe hota, ma to general room la shift jala ka specific private room la shift jala. Accordingly that we will consider this as a room comma bed allocations. A specific bed, oxygen bed hota, ka water bed hota, सिंपल बेड होता है. कई पेशंट्स जॉइंट्स से प्रॉब्लम्स असते तर ट्रैक्शन साठी वेगळे बेड्स येतात. अकॉर्डिंगली दैट वी कैन सिलेक्ट दिस. सो आई जस्ट एडेड द रूम बेड अलोकेशंस. ऑपरेशंस सेम. ऐड बेड edit. Bed. Search. Room comma bed. The most important part, billing charges. Edit. Charges for that specific room comma bed. We are taking the charges based on 12 hours. Now next part remaining, billing system. Okay, now, this billing system will be responsible to take the charges for the patients. आता पेशंटला चार्ज लावायचे तर ते कसे लावले जाणार आहेत. पहिलं डॉक्टर कोण होता, त्यांनी काय हे केली, ट्रीटमेंट दिली, त्याच्यानंतर काही लॅब वगैरे केल्यात का, आणि तो किती दिवस ऍडमिशन ऍडमिट होता आणि कुठले कुठले मेडिसिन्स त्याला वापरले गेले होते, त्या सगळ्यानुसार ही बिलिंग सिस्टीम काम करणार आहे. सो ऍड आय कन्सिडर दिस एज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ बिलिंग सिस्टीम. आय विल ऍड ऍट्रिब्यूट्स ओव्हर हिअर. सो considering this, generate bill salary slip. Operations will be billing system. Add billing details. Billing details. Search billing details. Then next, edit. Edit billing details. Now these billing details will be for the patients as well as for the staff, as well as for the doctors also. So these are the things which I have identified. Now you can reorganize it also. So you can select this and simply if you see this format and layout diagrams, you select this and you can able to select the layout diagrams also options. So format, reorganized part of things will be done. So organized in a simple, simplest manner. Now this I'll consider as a heart. So I'll keep this as a part over here. This will be the human beings. So I'll keep them at this, the left side. This will be an additional points. So I'll consider them over here. So appointments. I'll keep this as the center parts. Is any point missing? Yeah. Appointments and the names. This will be an optional part. Okay. But this billing system will be common, so I'm bringing it down again. The most important part are the center parts, just for my understanding. Now we need to define the relationship. If you are remembering what we did so far, we have identified different classes, we have named them properly, we have set some attributes to them, we have set some operations to them. It is not fixed, eh? Still, if there is a scope for the improvement, there is a scope for the changes, kai changes asil tar te apan karu shakto jase jase aplyala problem statement lakshat yeil. So the way we understand the problem statement, based on that we can add this part. So this is just an structure. Now I am representing in front of you. So what is an hospital management? Hospital management is nothing but an entity, or maybe it is a group of the different classes like hospital management, doctor, patient, nurse, then labs, rooms, appointments, and most important part as a billing system. So this is just a general structure we have represented. Now we get a chance here to represent the relationship among these different classifiers. आता हे वेगवेगळे क्लासेस आहेत आपल्याकडे. आता ह्यामध्ये आपल्याला काय करायचं, रिलेशनशिप डिफाईन करायची आहे. तर रिलेशनशिपचे आपण लास्ट टाइम डिस्कस केले, वेगवेगळे टाइप्स आहेत. कुठले कुठले? बेसिक्स टाइप स्टार्ट होतो असोसिएशन पासून. सेकंड असतो तुमचा डिरेक्टेड असोसिएशन, ज्याला आपण युनिट डायरेक्शनल असोसिएशन म्हणतो. देन असेल इज अ पार्ट ऑफ रिलेशनशिप. ना दॅट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ रिलेशनशिप वी कॅन रिप्रेझेंट इन टू स्टाईल. मे बी द फर्स्ट ॲज अ aggregation and second as a composition. Now aggregation and composition, what is the difference between aggregation and composition? Both are known as is a part of relationship. Aggregation when we use there is a weak relationship, and composition when there is a strong relationship. Then we have discussed generalization, means is a type of relationship. Then dependency is a part again. Then realization, that real-time implementation. These many different types of relationships we have discussed in terms of, again, with an association also specific to this. Or so in some cases, if you are not aware about this proper relationship, you can start with simple link also. So that link is again a simple basic type of a relationship to identify specifiers. So I'll simply start with this simple as an association relationship. So hospital management is linked with the patients. Association, again, I'll go with the bidirectional association with this also. I can minimize this for a specific class if it is not visible to you. I'll minimize this. So, or I can go with simply this as a 75%. Okay, now I'll go with this association again, same. I'll simply give the specific association relationship at this moment, because I am not a bit worried about the problem statement. I have not gone in detail with the problem statement, so I have just given the simple association relationship. Now just see here, association in multiplicity. In one hospital at a time, more than one patient may be available. But it may not be, or even I can show that association simply here. For that I need that properties over here. So I'll come to this. Okay, and I'll select this specific association, then generalization with this stereotype. You can add the stereotype visibility. So is specified? Yes, is specified. So in this way you can complete the simple class diagram. Okay, this defines relationship that we will discuss in upcoming part. Now at this moment just understand this. Okay, I have completed this diagram. I will take this diagram outside of this file, save as, export diagram, hospital management system. I have completed the class diagram and I'll save this. I'll take this on specific our group. Where is our group? Division. Okay, guys, I have shared one sample class diagram. Now I'm giving the task. Is any problem, whatever the steps I have shown to you? Any doubt so far? Yes, any doubt, any problem so far? Now what I will do, I'll take an attendance first and then I will give the sufficient time to complete the diagrams, class diagrams specifically for now you try to complete the class diagram for banking system, air transport system. I'll show you, no problem. Now you try to draw the class diagram for banking system. This is the simplest one that you are quite familiar with, this banking operations. So consider this banking system problem and try to draw the class diagram for the banking system. I'll take the attendance meanwhile. Okay, your attendance, roll number 1.
Present.
2.
Present, sir.
3. 4.
4 present, sir.
5.
Present, sir.
6.
Present.
7.
7 present, sir.
8.
Present.
9
present, sir.
10.
Present, sir.
11.
Present, sir.
12.
11 present, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14.
Present.
15.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17. 18. 19.
Present, sir.
20.
19. 20 present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
24.
Yes, sir.
25.
Present, sir.
26. 27.
27 present, sir.
28.
28 present, sir.
29.
Yes, sir. Present.
30.
Present, sir.
31. 32.
Present, sir.
33.
34. Present, sir.
35.
Yes, sir.
36.
Present, sir.
37.
Present, sir.
38.
Present, sir.
39. 40.
40 present, sir.
41.
Present. Present, sir.
42.
41 present.
42.
Present, sir.
43.
42 present, sir.
44.
44 present, sir.
45. 46. 47.
46 present, sir.
47. 48.
Present, sir.
49. 50. 50. 51. 52. 53. 54.
Present, sir.
55.
Present, sir.
56. 57. 58.
Present, sir.
58.
58, present, sir.
Okay. 59. 60. 61.
Present, sir.
62. 62. 63.
Present, sir. 63.
64.
Present, sir.
65.
Present.
66. 67.
Present, sir.
68.
Present, sir.
69.
Present, sir.
70.
Present, sir.
These are the absent numbers.
26 present, sir.
26 is present. Okay.
27 present.
Which one? One by one.
17 present.
17 present. Okay. Any other number? Roll number 41, 60, 62, 66. I have not received your answer sheet for OMD ISC 1. 41, 60, 62, 66. Are you there? Roll number 41, 60, 62, and 66. Mala tumcha ISC 1 milalelo nahi OMD cha. Should I consider absent for that? Or else you will send it in another 1 hour. Okay. Now I have given the task to you. You have to complete the class diagram for the banking system. So remaining time I'm giving to you to complete the class diagram for the banking system. The way I have shown you for this hospital management system. Now similar style, you have to draw the class diagram using the star UML for the banking system. Complete this task and keep the data with you, and at the end I will share the link. On the link you need to upload it. Okay. We'll take a pause here. You can continue the work.